Hello everyone, today is my first lecture in my channel. You are going to learn Java programming, and for learning Java programming you must have installed NetBeans IDE on your system. If you don't have NetBeans IDE, install it after downloading it from the netbeans.org, and when you download it, install it in your system as I have already installed it. So let's start. First of all, it is my NetBeans. I click it and it will run. Now this is your NetBeans IDEs. First of all, what will you do? Go to File, New Project, File, New Project. Here must be Java selected, and here Java application. Then you have click on Next. Now here give the name of your project. First program. Okay, now click on Finish. Your project have been created. So I'll introduce you first of all with the components and different parts of the project. So go to the project palette. I maximize it. You can see that this is your first program. Here is your source core packages. All packages are included in this source packages, and this is your first program package, in which this is your first program.java. It is a class, main class of the Java program. So we are going to start with the interfaces of the Java program or Java application. So to create Java interfaces, NetBeans facilitate us, and we will create a jfram here. So to create a jfram, click in your software, first program, then go to New and jframe form. Then give it the name. For example, I give it the class name main. This is a jframe class which named as main. This is the variable name of our jframe. So I'll after I tell you that what is jframe. Finish. So this is our main jframe. You can say that this is our main window which will appear on the screen when we will run this program. So go to source, right click and click on run. You can see that there is a run is you can say is not on. So go to design, and we will now design this window. I upload the first video, introduction video, where I introduce you with my software, and I'll tell you that how you can make your own software like that. So run it again. So go there. This is my program practice, and here is its main class practice. It is right click and run it. It's processing. Wait for a while. Here it is running. that is the interface of the software. Here is the watch, and these are different input fields, password, user, buttons, and all other things are there. And this is the main window of the software. So I'll tell you that how you can create these type of windows, these of interfaces for your application. So I minimize it. So go to your main. Here, where is the main? That I close all other programs from here. You can say that this is. So first of all, we will go to the palette. This is the palette manager. It has different component that we will place on our jframe, like buttons, text fields, combo boxes, text areas, panels, date choosers, scroll bars, check boxes, etc. Different, and I'll in each lecture I'll tell you that what are the purpose of these different components and how you can put in your software interface. So first of all, what you have to do, I'll tell you that swing control containers. Container means these are the classes, these are the things, these are the components that will be used to contain other components. So these are the containers, is like panel, tabbed pen to use different tabbed, scroll pen to use scroll bars on your interface. So first of all, we will put a panel on the jframe. When you click, drag and drop there, this is our panel. So I'll when you will go there, this is your panel. So right click on this panel, go to properties. These are important things. These are the properties, different properties. In this property dialog box, where you will choose according to your choice. So first of all is background color. What is the background color? Background color of this panel. So I'll use, for example, white color, as I use in my software. Okay, so this will background color is changed. Border means borders of the panel. Here you can different types of border. You can click any type of that you want to apply on your component. So line, I'll choose line border. These are the properties. Color of the border, rounded corners if you want, then check it. Thickness, how much border should we look, 1, 2, 3. So I'll choose as 1 and click OK. So these are the main properties of the panel that are usually used. Other we will learn with the time. So close it. Now you can drag it to the whole jframe. This is your main jframe, and we cover this jframe with the panel. So now we will create this title bar here. So go to the panel, put another panel in this panel, go on this panel, right click here, set layout, and go to the null layout. Now you can freely design this panel on this panel. So now click, drag it according to your panel here. Now go to the properties, background, as you can use a different type of different color. You can choose this color, and as I have created my own color with putting RGB values. If you know the RGB value of the your color that you want to apply, you will put there, and it will create a color code here. So I have the color code of my background is 1671B9. Okay,
Okay.
This is the color. I'll click it in, and RGBs, you can say that red, green and blue, these are the colors of my this hash code. You can say the color code or color code. Now these are the you can put the green, red, green and blue color properties there, and when you will enter it, it will create the hash code. You could write it with yourself, and next you will you have to enter a color code, and then it will apply on your component. So okay, and close it. Now you have to adjust it according to your jframe. So I'll use fire. Now you can say you can see that if you go there and see, click there, this is properly, and you can say that properly set over the window. And in this side you can say there the container line is far from this panel, and when you will drag it, it go out. So you can use properties of this J panel to set it. So now you can, how you can set it, I'll go to my magnifier plus, go there, right click here, and go to the properties. Now you can see these are the properties of this J panel. So scroll down it, and you can here, these are the width, height, X position and Y position. So X and Y position is on 1, and your width is 940 pixel. This is a measured pixel. So now if you increase it, for example 942, enter it, now this increased a little bit difference, 944, go there, it's more, because it's this black line must appear. So 943, okay, press enter, go there, 943 and enter. So you can see that here both sides are properly set. Okay, down. Now by dragging and dragging here, from here you can adjust its height. So this is your jframe. The jframe, or you will have to set the width of this container J panel according to the need. As the width of this jframe on my system or on my you can say that is go there, select none. Now width of this J panel is 1030, so I'll go there, width 1030 and close. You can see that it has been increased, so I increase this J frame also, and this also property. You can also see properties from the help properties. Go there and we got the properties and 1030, 1028 and enter. You can see it is properly set. Now go to your palette and text field that from here and put it on here. This is your text field. Right click on this J panel, set layout and null layout. Here right click, edit text, the text that will appear on the component. So I don't want to use any text. And then right click, properties, and these are the borders. These are the border. So I'll not use border here. Okay, now this is your tag is properly set. Now copy, right click or press Ctrl C and right click and click paste or Ctrl V. Your text field will be copied there and to drag it to the next. It is easy way, and because you create a one text field, you set the properties according to your need, and then you can copy that text field and use other text field like similar text style. Now you can say that there is a little bit difference. It is upper side and it is on the right click here properties, and you can say that a little bit different, so you have to minimize X position 35. Enter it. Now you can say that X, it means that when you decrease the Y size, the component will go up, but it will only in case when you have the container set as null background. So okay, layout null, sorry, close it. These are your two text field that you have applied. Okay, now we will caption, and we will write some text on it, that what is the purpose of that text field. So go to a palette and drag here J label. This is your J label class. Drag and drop it here. Now right click, properties. These are the properties. So J label text, user name, and then these are the foreground color, text color. Foreground color means the text color of that component. So white, you can use here fonts. As I used 12 plain and this font size Tahuma. Okay, close, and this is now Ctrl C and Ctrl V. Drag it here, right click, edit text. You can also change text from here. HX password field. Okay, now you have right here. Now what you have to do, you have to do closed, minimize buttons there. Before it, something next, for example, this C, Ctrl V, go there, right click, edit text, register. And Ctrl C, Ctrl V. You can press F2. As I press F2, you can also rename it and name password. So I'll increase its width. So and on my you can say interface that this is gray color, and when you point the mouse over it, it shows its white color. So I drag it down. You can change the properties of different things at once by press Ctrl button and click press control button, click on first component, and then don't release the control, click on other component. Both component will be selected, right click there, and properties. So these common properties will be here will be, and now you can choose the color of the, so both color of the both classes is changed. So you can select them, and you can also bold font, so you can make it bold, so it will appear clearly. Okay, now we'll go to the next part, and how you can make the close button. So you palette J label, put it there, adjust its size as you need. So right click and properties, I'll go there. And for we will use background color as red. Okay, now you can see that the background color of the J label is not changed. There is a property which is unchecked. Until you will not checked it, it will not doesn't show background color. It will pick the background color as the color of its container. Background color, the color of the J label is blue, so it's showing its blue color. When I put this J label there, then it is showing its color and white. So the name of that property is opaque. So here is the property opaque. So click it. Now the background color of the J label is changed. Foreground color we use white. Okay, in J text, right, uppercase X, close it. Oh, right click there, properties, here is the alignment of the text, so center it and increase the size of, and also make it bold 12. Okay, now it's your close button like this. Now in next lecture I'll tell you that how you can make this as a button, and we will click it, and your jframe will be closed. So right click there, properties, design. Now we will check this our interface and how it will look when it will run, executed, run on the system. So for this purpose I'll make some changes. Go to project. In your project there is your first program, go there, and here in the main method write the name of your jframe, name of this jframe that we appear on this tab, a main spelling like this. First of all, you have to write new main double parenthesis, and it is method dot set visible. This is the method set visible, and it is a boolean, so it may be true or false. True means that visibility will be when you will run the software, it will appear, and false means that this will hidden. Okay, now run this class, right click here, or you can run from here, run it. Here is your jframe, maximize it. This is your jframe, you can see that appear on the it's showing its other area, because we have to make some different settings and different things over there. Now after it, that will look like this, so don't worry about it. I'll tell you in the next lectures that how you can make more interesting thing on your interface like this one. Thanks for today.